Հոգեվերլուծություն գրգին գանտիպինք միասին, այսօր քիչմավելի անգլերեն մի դի խոսիմ մեր երդասարդներուն համար։ I'm going to speak today, I was asked to speak about caring and giving. These two are interrelated so much that one you cannot see without the other. You care, if you care you give, and if you give it means you care. And how much you give, it shows how much you care. So the two are interrelated. So when we look to the Bible for examples of this, we see Cain and Abel on the first stand, for example. Both they gave the product of what they do, one from the field, one from the animals. But it seems that Abel brought the best of the best, what he got. Whereas Cain just was doing kind of his duty, bringing some of his product. So that's why Abel's gift was received by God. And in the same way, in the example of the widow at the temple, Jesus tells about this story about the widow, who not only is a poor and a widow, but according to him, to Jesus, he gave all he had. She put the list of the monies, a penny maybe, but it was only Jesus who noticed that. Probably somebody like this widow would have given that gift secretly in a way, because maybe even she was ashamed so that people do not see how much little she was giving. But all that she got, and she gave all what she had. That's why Jesus said, now the treasury was filled because of her total giving. So in this sense, the giving, big or small, it doesn't matter how you give, how much of that you give. The others who gave, they gave big monies probably, rich people. But they gave from their leftovers, whereas this poor widow gave all she got. And obviously another example is the Good Samaritan, where caring and giving is interrelated. We see here too that the three people who were chosen by Jesus in this story, in this narrative, represent three different levels of the society, three representatives of the society. One is Levite. Levite are the priests of the Old Testament in the temple. Very respected, highly respected, I would say, people with their special status with the temple, who are expected to do the work of God. So when they were passing by, and this poor man was not only robbed but wounded and was laying on the side of the street, of the road, so Levite passing by, he passed in such a way that he ignored the person in question. Probably didn't have time to spare, neither money. The second person was a Pharisee. And the Pharisees are very respectable people in their society, high status obviously, dedicated to the temple and to the Jewish traditions. So one would expect that this kind of person would adhere to the need of this person who was wounded and maybe if left on this road would die as well. But he passed as well. The third person is Samaritan. The Samaritan at this time, we are talking about the period of Jesus working in Palestine, was the north part of Judea. And because the Samaritans, the Jewish people of Samaritans, were mixed with pagans and non-Jewish people, that's why by the Jews, the Samaritans were regarded as not pure Jewish people. So they usually looked down to the Samaritans as not truly pure Jewish people who had mixed their tradition with pagan other faith and traditions. So this person was not respected in Jewish society and was not regarded high and that he will do a good job. But this man, immediately as he saw this person, without knowing obviously who he is, he's a Jew or whatever religion or ethnic background he had, he dealt with the, immediately with the immediate needs of this person, treated the wound, and then took him to a special inn where they could care and nurture him so that he would be healed, and then let him go to his business. So which of the three, Jesus says, was the exemplary person who did his share of work of giving and caring, if not this last person, the Samaritan? That's why he's referred as Good Samaritan, who cared for the person, the unknown friend of his, to make sure that he would live and continue his work to praise God. Obviously, the best example of giving is Jesus' example, who gave his life. He gave his life because life is the... We don't have any rich or anything better than our life. That's the possession, and the best thing in our world is our lives. Without our lives, we don't have anything else that remains. So when you give your life for something, you sacrifice, means that that something is better than your own life. You esteem as such. So when Jesus gave his life on the cross for humanity, it showed that he loved humanity so much, he cared for us so much, that he gave his very life for our salvation. And through his death, he knew that disciples will come together eventually by hearing the good news of the resurrection, and then they will go on and carry spreading the good news to all corners of the world, whereby people can hear and adhere to the good traditions what Jesus left through his disciples to us. And that's what happened as well. Today, for example, we, as adherers of Christian faith, as adherers of our Lord Jesus, we try to emulate what the first disciples did, what Jesus himself did. So it is important then for us, during this period of difficulties when we pass through, and still the world is passing through, and we don't know when this tragedy will end. People are getting hurt, are dying left and right. Some have no medicine or cure, others are indifferent. But we are paying the penalty for our indifference in a way. But we thank God in this country that at least so far we are doing better than most in the rest of the world. But again, what we have, what we do with what we have, how we share that with not only our friends, our relatives, our people we know as such, but even those who we don't know, as in the example of the Good Samaritan. And sometimes we think that caring and giving is necessarily financial, it has to be big money. First, it must be big money, as in the example of the widow we've seen. Second, it doesn't need our giving has to be that in particular in financial means and ways. Giving means to care. To care, in order to care, you have to show attitude, to respect, to give your time, to make effort, and much, much importantly, to give your love. If you love, it doesn't matter who the person is, if you love the person as he is, as your brother or your sister, the brother or sister which you don't have, But in this case, it's the brother and sister which you don't have. It comes and needs your help and assistance in whatever manner it is. Sometimes, just a smile, just a good morning, just help in any matter, in any way, by which we can show that we care for them. And caring, in this case, shows that we love them in a mysterious, in a hidden way that people didn't know before, let's say. And when they see our love, then they will believe that this life is worthwhile to live, to continue. So I hope that during this period in particular, when we had opportunities, when our abilities were tested in a way, sometimes to the extreme, that how much we care for one another, how much we can give for one another. And obviously, eventually it comes, because if you give, if you help others, we help Christ. The mission of the Christian faith is helping others in humanity, because in humanity is the image of our Lord. So if we give then, and if we care, how much we have to care much more for our Lord, for our faith, that every day we live, we survive, and how much we give back from what we earn in this life, with all the gifts given to us, what we return in resource back to our Lord. So that's what remains eventually towards the end of our life. As one of our poets, Tekian, has said, what is remained from life to me, but not even simply what I have given to the others. So I give you this thought with you this day, hoping that you will think about it and act accordingly. Thank you.